Oh yes, the most anticipated mid-range smartphone is here, the Poco F5 and the Poco F5 Pro. And as expected, they come with some very impressive specs. So here are the key differences that you should know before deciding which one is right for you, because it's not an easy decision as you think. Now let's begin with what comes inside of the box. Now the interesting thing about it is that both come with the same items inside of the box, which are the clear TPU case, a USB A to USB-C cable, and the 67W charger. Now in terms of the build quality and design, before going into the numbers, from an aesthetic point of view, you can immediately tell the difference between both phones. Now the Poco F5 comes with three circular designs to separate each of the camera modules, and the Poco F5 Pro has a more streamlined squared camera array design. Now this would be a personal preference on which looks better, but in my humble opinion, I prefer how the Pro looks because I do like how it looks more professional and clean. And because of the difference of the camera arrays, when it comes to the wobble ability, yep, I just made that word up. The Poco F5 got some moves while typing on the surface, but the Poco F5 Pro is as steady as a rock, except when you're tap dancing towards the left side of the phone on those Qs, As and Shift keys on the virtual keyboard. Now when it comes to the Poco F5's finish, the black variant has a carbon fiber style that even extends around the camera module, but this glossy finish is a magnet for fingerprints, so if you're into creating modern art with your smudges, then this one is for you. Then moving on to the Poco F5 Pro, its finish is like the long lost twin of the Xiaomi 13 that I reviewed recently. Glossy, white and very sleek. Now it will also attract fingerprints, but it's not as obvious as the black color variant of the Poco F5. And it keeps the more curved edges at the sides, very similar to the previous Poco generation smartphones. Now I have to admit that I do prefer the squared frame design of the non-pro variant more, since I'm not usually a fan of a curved design. And speaking of the frames of the phone, each of the phone has a matte finish, keeping the phone more balanced in terms of having better grip of the phone, where the Poco F5 has the same black color finish, where the Poco F5 Pro has a silver finish instead. Now overall, the Poco F5 is slightly slimmer and also lighter, weighing at 181 grams. It is available in white, blue and black. On the other hand, the Poco F5 Pro weighs at 204 grams and it comes in black and white. Now the good news is that both phones does feel very good and grippy in the hands. Then both the Poco F5 and the Poco F5 Pro are IP53 splash proof protected, offering you that peace of mind when it comes to accidental water exposure. It has dual speakers and IR blaster and support for NFC. Then the final face off is the Poco F5 has the side fingerprint sensor and also the trusty 3.5mm headphones jack, while the Poco F5 Pro opts for an in-display fingerprint sensor, but sorry headphone jack lovers, because the Pro variant does not have a headphones jack. So overall, which one do I prefer? Well, if you're a long time, viewer, you know that I'm all about the squared shape on the Poco F5, but the Poco F5 Pro's camera array and the amazing stunning white finish, it's like a match made in heaven. So it is the Pro for me, but do let me know which design that you prefer in the comment section below. Do you have the same choice as me? Alright, let's move on to the displays, because both has the same display size of 6.67 inch Flow AMOLED dot display, where the Poco F5 has a resolution of FHD plus 2400 by 1080 pixels, while the F5 Pro features a higher WQHD plus resolution of 3200 by 1440 pixels. Now both phones offers up to 120Hz refresh rate, but the Poco F5 Pro has a higher touch sampling rate of up to 480Hz compared to 240Hz on the F5. Now to be honest, that is something that I didn't find very noticeable, so this would be more of numbers than actual usage. And both screens also has Corning Gorilla Glass 5 protection. And while both phones have Widevine L1 high quality playback specification on Netflix with full HD plus playback resolution and HDR10 as well, I find it extremely weird that the Nan Pro has Dolby Vision support but the Pro does not. Hopefully, a software update could fix this, as I don't think it is a chipset limitation, which I'll dive in deeper into the chipset use for both phones later on in this video. Next, in the camera department, both phones has a similar camera setups, featuring a 64MP f1.79 main camera with OIS, an 8MP f2.2 ultrawide camera, and a 2MP f2.4 macro camera. Yay, macro camera. Now, even though both phones have the same exact camera, I still decided to take pictures on both phones just to see if there were any differences that I could see. And to my surprise, there were some differences, because looking at these two ultra-wide shots, I prefer how the images look on the Poco F5, where the skies were more natural in color and the red Berhenti sign on the Nan Pro was more color accurate compared to the image on the Poco F5 Pro. Now, even the gray painting on the building was more accurate as well on the Poco F5. However, when it comes to the main lenses, they were close to each other, but then again, with more saturation at the skies area, and so was the 2x zoom image. Now, speaking of zoom, you can zoom digitally up to 10 times on both phones. Then portrait mode on both look great at a glance with a very good subject to background blur. But if you zoom in close, you'll find that the edge detection on the Poco F5 was just a tad bit better. So I noticed something funky with the front camera's image processing, because in the selfie portrait mode, I set the aperture to f2.5 on both. But the Nan Pro's background blur was a little overboard compared to the Pro. Now, as someone who's practically married to a manual lens when I shoot all of my YouTube videos, I can tell you that the Pro's bokeh is spot on. So it looks like the Nan Pro's front cameras need some tuning on the image processing. So in the battle of the skin tones and overall selfie, the Poco F5 Pro takes the win. Now, another area where there was quite a difference in the video recording resolution is the Poco F5 Pro has the advantage of supporting both 4K 60fps and 8K 24 frames per second video recording, while the Poco F5 only supports up to 4K video recording at 30fps. Now, keep in mind that all of the high resolution as mentioned are only for the main rear lenses as mentioned, as the video recording on the ultra-wide cameras are still limited to 1080p 30fps for the Nan Pro and up to 60fps on the Pro. Now, another quirk that I found on the Pro variant is that while it does have HDR that you can toggle it on while on video mode, but you're only limited to the main lens. So keep in mind, if you really need to record in the HDR mode, that you can only use the main lens. Then, as usual, the front camera can only record up to 1080p 60fps, where the image stabilization was really good, but the dynamic range wasn't as good, as you can see with the brightly exposed skies. So it does seem that as of this moment, if you love taking photos, the Poco F5 is better. But if you love shooting videos, then the Poco F5 Pro should be your pick. And of course, stay tuned for my in-depth camera review during my full video review of the phone. Now, under the hood, the Poco F5 is powered by the Snapdragon 7 Plus Gen 2 chipset, while the Poco F5 Pro features a more powerful Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 chipset. Now, this means that the Poco F5 Pro will provide more processing power for gaming and other demanding tasks. So, in a nutshell, to help you in your purchase decision, let me explain the differences between both of the chipsets, as there are two main areas to consider, which is performance and efficiency. Now, as for performance, the Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 packs a bigger punch than the 7 Plus Gen 2. So if you're all about gaming, video editing, or even multitasking like a pro, then this one is your winner. But if you're after a balance of performance and cost efficiency, without needing the top dog, then yes, the Snapdragon 7 Plus Gen 2 is still a very solid choice. Now, as for efficiency, the Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 being a powerhouse that it is, it might be a little more power hungry, potentially leading to a short battery life compared to the 7 Plus Gen 2. So if battery life and efficiency is what you need, then the Snapdragon 7 Plus Gen 2 is your go-to. And as usual, stay tuned for my full video review on Adam Lobo TV, where I'll put these chipsets through their real-world paces. So hit the subscribe button if you guys haven't done so, and let's find out together. So the good news is that both devices comes with the LPDDR5 RAM and UFS 3.1 storage. Now both phones also feature the dynamic RAM expansion to ensure smooth multitasking and app performance. And once again, stay tuned for the exact RAM and storage available here in Malaysia and also globally as well, which I'll leave it in the pinned comment below. Now, as for battery life, the Poco F5 has a 5000 mAh battery, and while the Poco F5 Pro comes with a slightly larger 5160 mAh battery, I would love to find out how much of a battery life that I would get with the slightly 160 mAh battery, which you will find out in my full video review of the phones. However, if you prefer wireless charging, then the bad news is that the regular Poco F5 does not have one, but the Poco F5 Pro has a wireless charging up to 30 watts. Then as for software, both the phones run on MIUI version 14 for Poco on Android 13. And as of the recording of this video, the Poco F5 is at MIUI version 14.0.2 and the Poco F5 Pro is at version 14.0.4. And while I was recording this video, the price of these two phones were not announced yet, so I'll leave a pinned comment below in terms of the price for both. And with this, do let me know which one of these two phones that you would like for me to review first, or shall I do a comparison between the previous King of Pocos, the Poco F3.